Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host Jason Turner, available for code reviews, contracting, and on-site training. Now, this episode is going to be one that is 100% directly related to the game stuff that I'm doing, and I need to get this one out of the way so that in a future game episode I can apply these things. So we're going to talk a little bit about allocators, and I will flat out say I am not an expert in how allocators work with C++. But I did watch this excellent video, which I currently have up on the screen and I will attempt to remember to link to in the notes, called Getting Allocators Out of Our Way from Pablo Helpern and Alistair Meredith. Now, these two gentlemen are talking about specifically using allocators in a more transparent way. They want to make a proposal that would come in probably C++ 23 or something like that, where it would make using custom allocators a little bit more automatic. But I took away from this an example of just how to use allocators that I had never seen before. So I'm going to put the compiler in C++ 17 mode here, just to prove a point that this isn't requiring C++ 20 or anything. This should be in any compiler that you have available right now with C++ 17 or so. And we're going to use the polymorphic memory resource, PMR. I'm going to just start with vector. And I'm going to create a quick vector using a polymorphic memory resource here. So what we need is a local memory, and this is will be our buffer of data on the stack. I'm going to pre-initialize this. I'm going to create it with 2048 bytes, just as a number to have. And then I'm going to be using things in the PMR resource namespace now. So this is the monotonic buffer resource, and I'm just going to call this my resource, and it's going to take my stack buff object and the size of the stack buff. So that's just how many bytes this thing has. This is a C style array here that I'm doing, but you could almost certainly do this just as easily with a C++ array. And now I am going to actually use this polymorphic memory resource in a vector. So I can pass it an initializer list and initialize it with six objects or whatever. And then I can pass it a link to this thing. And that's basically just how simple it is. Now, we're not going to dig into the compiler explorer code here because it does generate quite a bit more code than just using vector would in this case. But what have we actually accomplished? And let's walk through this. So I have created this memory here on the stack, and then this resource memory, monotonic buffer resource object that is created with a pointer to this thing. And now my vector is actually using this resource. So I'm currently using, this is a vector of integers, that is 4 times 6 is 24. I'm using 24 bytes of the 2048 that I had available. If I were to go and create a second vector, these two vectors are sharing the same buffer. So I can drastically reduce the amount of dynamic allocations that I am doing. This is a really, from a programmer's perspective, pretty straightforward and easy way of using a custom allocator and reducing the number of allocations that you have. Now, obviously, you're going to be wondering, what exactly impact is this going to really have on my code? To which point I am going to bring you to QuickBench. This is quick-bench.com. If you have never been here, it is definitely a useful tool. Now, I wanted to test the actual impact on this. So I am creating lists here. This is a list of things and a list of things. And these two lists have 20 elements in them separately. So I've got, let me get those notes out of the way here. I'm going to run a benchmark that compares my polymorphic memory resource, PMR, with this list that creates 20 using this guy and the list that creates 20 not using anything special. Now, this one has to do 20 separate allocations. That is how standard list works. It must allocate each item in a separate dynamic allocation. This one is going to do one stack allocation, zero heap allocations, and then it's going to create these 20 objects in this memory buffer. So let's just go ahead and run this benchmark and see what the difference is. We have to have a compiler and standard library combination selected where it can find this correctly. And we run it, and the website's going to, in the back end, run a benchmark for us, and it will show us the results. Okay, so here we have it. Our PMR list is 3.6 times faster than using a regular list. And so let's try to make a comparison with how this compares with vector. Now we're in GCC 9.2, which I don't think can do any kind of heap elision here. So we're going to be still seeing heap allocations with vector, and vector should always be our default. Let's see what happens. Okay, so we can see that the vector here is really, really fast. It is 7.6 times faster than PMR list, but now we can get the behavior of something like a list at speeds approaching that of a vector. So let's go ahead and do one final test and see what we get if we can avoid entirely the dynamic heap allocations for vector by also using a PMR vector. Now I am going to, you wouldn't do something like this in isolation like this. This is something that you would, the entire point of this would be to reuse the same memory resources for multiple objects of probably differing types. But I want to try to bring this home and say, okay, we've got multiple lists or multiple vectors doing these things. And some cases they get to share the same memory resource, and in other cases they're doing their own thing. So I think this is a little bit perhaps more realistic to code that we would actually be using. And it certainly will be more realistic to the code that I will be using in my game project. All right, so when we've got multiple things happening here, so the regular list is now, let's see, it's still 3.5 times slower than, or 3.5 times faster than regular list. So we didn't gain a whole lot there, even though we're creating two of these in each one. The regular vector, let's see, the PMR vector is now 2.3 times faster than regular vector. So yeah, so be aware of this. Now, don't even get me started on things like standard map. One of the things that makes map so incredibly slow in some use cases is the fact that it also has to do a dynamic allocation for each node. And that's also true for unordered map. So yeah, be aware of these PMR resources and check them out on CPP reference and see how you can utilize them in your code. I mean, depending on what you need to do, this can be an absolutely incredibly significant performance difference with relatively little pain from the perspective of the programmer, because you don't have to specify the type of allocator that you're using here, since it's using the polymorphic one, which basically means it's taking a pointer to a thing and making a virtual function call every single time it needs to allocate memory. But hey, there's clearly a win here. So check this out. And thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you learned something about this and that you check out these PMR resources in your standard library.